I originally did a science degree majoring in anatomy and physiology, and was very fortunate to be offered an honours year at the end of that in physiology with what turned out to be one of the best supervisors in the department, and that was Professor Mark Rowe. And the thing about the honours year is it is a perfect segue to a PhD. And whilst most people who do honours don't necessarily always aspire to doing a PhD, it is the perfect segue in that it's the first time you stop being a student and start being a scientist, if you like, or an academic. And you stop studying and you start using the skills that you've been taught. And all those skills and all those subjects that you thought, when am I ever going to use this stuff? And this is the forum in which you do use all of it. And that's the extraordinary thing about moving through, you know, particularly in science, through a degree, honours and then PhD. You're actually going to use all the things that you learn. And it was brilliant because in the honours year, you learn about teaching, tutoring, you learn about analysis, you learn about structuring experiments and, you know, scientific processes. And, you know, all the things that, you know, all the skills one needs to basically become a scientist. And it's a fascinating journey. And, you know, my supervisor taught me how to present, how to write, how to be critical of things and how to analyze data correctly and use statistics properly. And so at the end of the honors year, I was fortunate enough to get first class with my two close friends at the time who also did an honors year. So I received first class honors and was given the opportunity to, thanks to the coveted Commonwealth postgraduate scholarship, to go on and do a PhD. And actually there was no question I wasn't going to do that because I was flying high on first class honors and getting a scholarship to go on. I was perfectly in tune at the time in, you know, how the whole process worked. And I was good at it. I worked extremely hard in the honors year. Anyway, the PhD was a phenomenal experience. And it was, as I mentioned, an extension of the honors year in many ways. And, you know, there was a certain set of experiments that were laid out. And I completed all those experiments. And after 3 years, I'd published a number of papers and I did everything except, you know, put it into a thesis format, if you like. But it was a brilliant experience with a supervisor. He was an absolutely brilliant teacher and a mentor to me. And in fact, all the skills, or many of those skills that he was absolutely fastidious in you know, me being an excellent, you know, me being excellent at, I use today all the time. Presentation skills, writing skills. And I still have his voice in my head telling me, no, that's not the way you should write that. Or, you know, red pens through everything. But he was a fantastic mentor. And that sort of way of thinking, scientific way of thinking that he instilled has meant I'm very good at a lot of things thanks to that experience.